Good morning, Standard 9 students. Today I shall be teaching you Act 2, Scene 8. Okay. Now in this scene, Shylock has come to know about his daughter Jessica running away with a Christian lover, Lorenzo, along with his ducats, jewelry, and precious stone. So in this case, now Shylock, from the very beginning, he hated the Christians. And now his daughter has run away with a Christian. So he is infuriated. He is very, very angry now with the Christians. Because he feels that the Christians are responsible for boycotting or brainwashing his daughter, and along with her, all his wealth is also gone. So now his Antonio, we know Shylock expressed his hatred to Antonio by saying, "I hate him because he is a Christian." Now, there is a big rumor about this Antonio's ship. Now, Antonio's ship means we don't know, but there is a rumor that a ship from Venice had been wrecked. And everyone assumes perhaps this ship may belong to Antonio. So his friends, Celerino and Solanio, they were in Venice in a street. Okay. And now they are going to tell us something about this ship that has been wrecked. Now, these two characters in the play, remember what I'm telling you. A question will be asked, what is the importance or what is the significance of Celerino and Solanio being in the play? Now these two people, the role that they actually play is that Shakespeare could not bring all the scenes onto the stage. Once again, Shakespeare could not bring any kind of scenes onto the stage. So with the help of Celerino and Solanio, he takes us somewhere else. So in their dialogues, we come to know what had taken place in the harbor, or what had taken place in the Rialto, or what has taken place here and there. Because those places cannot be brought onto the stage. So in their dialogue, these two people mention those areas that cannot be brought onto the stage. That is the significance of Celerino and Solanio in this play. Remember this. Okay. Celerino, "Wild man, I saw Bassanio under sail. With him is Graciano gone along, and in their ship, I am sure, Lorenzo is not." So next day, when these two friends meet, now Celerino is saying that he saw Bassanio sailing to Belmont. Okay, because he has to go and take part in the lottery system. And along with Bassanio, they are sure that Graciano was with him. And they were also sure that Lorenzo was not with Bassanio, though they had planned to run away during the party given by or hosted by Bassanio. But the rumor was perhaps Lorenzo and Jessica may have run away and they may be in Bassanio's ship. So this piece of information has been given that Graciano is with Bassanio, but not Lorenzo. Now, Solanio, the villain Jew, that is, with outcries raised the Duke, who were with him to search Bassanio's ship. Like I told you, Shylock has come to know that his daughter has run away. So he assumes that Jessica and Lorenzo have run away in Bassanio's ship. So he had raised the Duke, means he has pressurized the Duke that you have to check, inspect Bassanio's ship. Definitely I will get my daughter. So he was 101% sure that Lorenzo and Jessica will be found in Bassanio's ship. Who went with him to search Bassanio's ship? Salarino. He came too late. When the Duke and Shylock arrived the spot, Bassanio had already set sail. Means he had already left the shore and now he is gone. The ship was under sail. But then the Duke was given to understand that in a gondola were seen together Lorenzo and his amorous Jessica. Okay. Then over there they came to know that Jessica and Lorenzo, they had caught a gondola. Now a gondola is a vanishing boat. Like how in Jammu and Kashmir we have the shikaras or the houseboats. Like that in Venice you have a vanishing boat called a gondola. And it was seen by many people that Lorenzo and Jessica were found traveling in that. Okay. Besides, Antonio certified the Duke that they were not with Bassanio in his ship. And above all, Antonio, a very close friend to Bassanio, he also confirmed the Duke that Lorenzo and Jessica are not traveling in Bassanio's ship. Now, certified by Antonio, it means the Duke has got a lot of respect for Antonio. Why? Because Antonio is a rich merchant in Venice. Not only being rich, he is also commonly or very popularly known for his generosity and kindness and how he helps the needy. So, and he confirmed the Duke that Lorenzo and Jessica are not traveling in Bassanio's ship. And the Duke has to, what do you say, listen or be satisfied with the answer given by Antonio. Salerno, I never heard a passion so confused. So never in my life I have seen somebody so confused. So strange, outrageous and variable as the dog Jew did utter in the streets. So never before in my life I have ever seen Shylock behave in a very strange, outrageous manner. Now remember, Shylock is a serious person. He is a moneylender. He is a cruel man. Okay, he is not an extrovert. He is not a very forward person to enjoy merriment and all that. But there was something very strange while he was walking on the streets, because he was very angry. Alright, he was angry with his daughter, he was angry with, because she has taken all the wealth and gone, all his money and jewelries and everything. So he was very much or very, very annoyed or angry with his daughter. Okay, now he says the strange behavior. Means we do not know actually for what he is lamenting or for what he is crying for. Sometimes he's saying, oh my daughter. Then he's saying, oh my ducats. Now we don't know whether he is feeling sorry for the loss of his daughter or for the loss of his wealth. O my daughter, fled with a Christian. Then again he is fretting or thinking about his daughter running away with a Christian. What a shameful thing she has done. Again, O my Christian ducats. Now he's feeling more hurt that all his money is now going to go to a Christian, that is going to go to Lorenzo. For whatever wealth she has stolen from her father's house, now Lorenzo is going to get the benefit of it. So they don't know for what he was crying, for what he was shouting like a madman, whether he's feeling sorry for the loss of his daughter, or whether he's feeling sorry for the loss of his wealth, or whether he's feeling sorry because a Christian is going to use his wealth. So everyone was very strange and he was behaving like a madman. Justice, the law, my ducats and my daughter. A sealed bag, two sealed bags of ducats, of double ducats stolen from me by my daughter. So now he's looking for justice. He is now going to fight the law. So because I want my daughter back, I want my ducats back, because she has taken two sealed bags and now he's complaining how much of money she has already stolen from him. And he cannot believe that his own daughter has betrayed him. So now he's going to fight for justice. And jewels, two stones, two rich and precious stones, stolen by my daughter. Justice, find the girl. She had the stones upon her and the ducats. So he cannot believe his own eyes that his own daughter, his own blood and flesh, okay, has stolen all these precious and costly things from him. Celerino, why all the boys in Venice follow him, crying his stones, his daughter and his ducats? He says, now even the young boys, when they saw the strange behavior of Shylock, shouting, oh my daughter, oh my ducats, oh my daughter fled with the Christian, oh my Christian ducats, the boys were also repeating. They were also like mad people following him down the streets and repeating whatever he was saying. So it was a very funny scene to see many young boys running behind him and imitating Shylock. And again tomorrow I shall continue with this video. I'll be sending some written work. Please write and learn. Thank you.